Hello, I am Shweta Verma and we are going to learn a very interesting topic in science, and our today topic is substance in the surrounding, and in that subtopics we are going to learn more about properties of a substance. Here I have written down certain properties of a substance. Let us see these all properties one by one with the example. Now what is this? As we all know, this is an chalk. Chalk are very soft. We can divide the chalk into many pieces. The substance which can divide it into small particle like a dust and these particles, this kind of particles. This kind of substance is called as a brittle substance, and the property is known as a brittleness. And the next property is elasticity. We have in our home, we have different kind of elastic substance like elastic balls, rubber band. When you apply the force on such items or such particles like this, when you apply force on any material, when it change its position and it extend like this, and when you remove the force from that substance and again it come back to its original position or in shape, this kind of material is called as an elastic material. And the property is known as a elasticity. And the next property is fluidity. What do you mean by the fluidity word? Fluidity means certain things which can flow from higher rate to the lower rate. Let us see here certain substance which can flow from higher level to the lower level. First we will take an example of water. Just observe very carefully the rate of flow of substance. This is a water. Water can easily flow from upper side to the lower side. Whereas if you take at the same time honey, if you take an example of honey, the flow rate of honey is slower than the water. And the third one is, if you take an example of glue, just observe the flow rate of this fluid. Observe carefully. If you must have observed the all the three substances as flowing from higher level to the lower level at a different rate, this property is called as a fluidity. Each and every substance flow down in a different rate. This is called as a fluidity of a substance. And the next one is, and the next property is solubility. As the word is solubility, means what? Certain thing which can dissolve in water. Let us take an example of salt and the water. This is what? Water. If you add salt in water and stir it like this, after some time you must have observed that salt is completely dissolved in water and make an one transparent solution. This is called as a solubility. And take one more example here. I have taken the water and in that we are going to add a honey. If you observe this honey and oil, you have observed this, it honey and oil, and if you mix, you can see that honey is partially dissolved in water, whereas the oil does not dissolve in water. It settled on the upper side. You must have seen the clearly the droplets had settled on the upper side. This shows that certain substance does not dissolve in water. Such substance is called as an insoluble substance. And the next property is transparency. Transparency means what? When you see the things from one side to the another side through any medium, and that things from the other side looks very clear like this. If you take in water or any substance, you see the things from one side to the other side and it looks very clear. You must have to do the experiment at home and observe this. You can see the things from that side very clearly. Such substance is called as a transparent, and that property is called as a transparency. There the other example like a mirror, water, transparent glass. There are various substance which act as a transparent medium, and that property is called as a transparency. And the one of the last property is hardness. As a word, you can get to know the hardness means what? The certain substance which are very hard in nature, like a duster. If I tell you to break it, will you able to break it? I don't think so you can. Chalk is very easily, you can break it in the class and you are doing, I know very well. But if I tell you to break this duster, will you? No. Because that are very hard. Like a steel scale, that are very hard to break it. Such substance is called as a hard substance, and their property is called as a hardness. So I think you must have understood very well about all these properties. Must have understood all these topics very thoroughly. Let us recap one more time what we have learned today. First properties was brittleness, a substance which are brittle in nature, and their property is called as a brittleness. And the second is elasticity, the substance which are elastic in nature, and their property is called as a elasticity. Third one is fluidity, the substance which can flow from higher level to the lower, higher to the lower level at a different rate, that substance is called as the fluidity. And the fourth one is solubility, the substance which can easily dissolve in water and make one transparent layer, that is called as a solubility. And the fifth one is transparency, the substance, many substances we can see from the one side to the another side with the help of any transparent medium. That is called as a transparent substance, and the property is known as a transparency. The sixth one is hardness. Hardness, the certain substance which are hard in nature, which cannot break very easily, that substance is called as a hard substance, and the property is known as a hardness. Just go through all this property once again, read it. If you have any doubt, let me know. And now take out your homework. You have to write each and every properties example in your own word, what you have observed in your surrounding. Write down at least one or two example of each and every property. That is your homework you have to write in your notebook. Sleep well, eat well, and stay at home safe. Thank you.